And welcome back to Let's Play Star Trek, 25th anniversary.
Another fine match.
I still have a cold. I'm sorry. It sucks.
Priority message from Starfleet.
On screen, Lieutenant.
We have reports of an undetermined number of Elasi pirate ships in your sector. You are ordered to proceed to the Harlequin star system immediately and investigate. Starfleet out.
Okay, so brought to you by the power of NyQuil. My voice is really messed up. I do not normally sound like this. Anyway, navigational map. Okay, I know it's up here. It's the left one by the end of our last video. I was able to look ahead and find out where the hell the Harlequin star system is, and it's this one. So I believe this is episode 4 of 7.
Two Elasi ships approaching fast, Captain. I'm also picking up an ion trail from a small ship, probably a scout. It left the sector just as we arrived. It appears likely that we interrupted the pirate attack on the scout.
Message from the Elasi captain, sir.
We'll show you what happens to those who come between us and our prey. Prepare to die!
Target analysis.
Oh, no. Weapons?
Enemy weapons.
Shields.
Raising shields.
Okay, these guys are down here. I'm a little out of practice here. Whoop, I saw him.
Target analysis off.
Okay, we need to repair, which is what?
Target analysis off.
Hold on. D. Is it this?
Aye, sir.
Target analysis off.
We got two ships here, so... Oh, right. They just flew over on the other side of the map right now.
Engines repaired, Captain.
Good, I actually repaired the right thing. Hello, hello, I see you. Gotcha. I don't know which one I was fighting. This could be a lengthy battle.
Target analysis on.
Hold on.
Target analysis on.
Engine again.
Aye, sir.
Target analysis on.
Two. Great fun. Why don't we always try to attack the yellow one? Going for that yellow one every time. Because they're appearing in the middle of all this.
Target analysis off.
Oh, I messed up.
Aye, sir.
Yellow one. That other one's really fast.
Target analysis off.
I think we're...
Weapons are offline.
I'm doomed.
Target analysis off.
Weapons are offline?
Aye, sir. The shields are falling!
Oh, no.
Weapons are offline!
Target analysis off.
Not good.
The shields are falling! Our weapons are offline!
Target analysis off.
I'm trying to use them anyway, you know.
Target analysis off.
Yeah, these things are not... What do we... Shields.
Aye, sir.
Let's get that back first.
Target analysis off.
The Enterprise has been destroyed. Load of previously saved failure.
Okay.
Aye, sir.
I'm not sure which one I'm analyzing. You should be more damaged than that.
Aye, sir.
One of them is gone. He went into cloak. I figured he would come back out of cloak, but I still don't see him.
Engines repaired, Captain.
Yay.
Aye, sir.
Shields. You're over here. No, you're not. What? Let's go faster. If that didn't... Hitting the number keys is supposed to make you go faster. I can't really tell the difference. Yeah, I guess I can a little bit. 9 is really fast. Where are you? And we're fine right now. Great. If I could hit the guy, it'd be great. Yeah, good. May you die in a big ball of fiery death. How could we miss with the photon torpedoes? We were right there. Hey. Get back here. Not so tough now that it's just one of you, huh?
Shields repaired, Captain.
Yay, I thought they already were, actually. Get over here. My God. Can we go faster? How is this faster? How is he shooting us? He's nowhere near us. I can't get him closer than this. Now he's up here. Oh, I think the higher numbers are slower then? I think it's 2 through 0, but I figured 2 would be slowest. Okay, so I'm at 2. Now we're able to keep up with him, mostly.
Target analysis on.
He's damaged. He's pretty bad shape.
Target analysis off.
This is bridge? Oh, shields first, I guess.
Aye, sir.
Now we need our view screen
bridge
back.
Bridge repaired, Captain.
Oh wait, it's sensors. This is sensors.
Aye, sir.
You can see him.
The ion trail of the scout ship leads to the Harrison system, Captain.
He left.
Picking up the subspace signal, sir. It's very weak.
Patch it through, Lieutenant.
Enterprise? Is that you, Kirk? Friend Kirk. I can't believe they sent you to rescue me.
That sounds like... No, please, say it isn't.
I have a visual signal now, sir.
You've come to help me, Kirk.
Oh, no.
You've got to help me. I have a terrible misunderstanding with the Elasi traders. Traders!
Pirates.
They're out to kill me, Kirk.
Fancy that.
No, see, Kirk. I sold my mug's miracle to climbers in perfectly good faith. A little sideline work, you understand? Now they won't leave me alone. No. They're out tracking me again. I can't send coordinates. You have to come protect me. I'm a registered ship with the Federation. Mud out.
I'm afraid his ship is registered, Captain, and regulations require we respond to his distress signal.
Nah. Mr. Scott, can we fix the freaking sensors?
Aye, sir.
Computer analysis suggests 91.331% chance that the speaker was Harcourt Fenton Mudd, Harry, to his friends.
Sensors repaired, Captain.
Thank you. I noticed. Shields?
Aye, sir.
Computer. Mudd.
Mudd. Harcourt Fenton. Harcourt Fenton, Harry, Mudd. Is one of the most infamous criminals at large in the Federation. A notorious con artist and troublemaker, Mudd has been imprisoned numerous times for petty crimes. While Mudd is not considered physically dangerous, he is quite devious and often uses dangerous means to ensure the success of his schemes. Starfleet captains who encounter Harry Mudd should be extremely wary.
She says what we're all thinking. I don't know if I've ever looked up Elasi.
Elasi Prime. A binary star system, which one inhabited planet, Menalvagor, is currently undergoing a revolution between factions which survive from raiding Federation ships and factions that wish to make peace with the Federation. Several continents were colonized centuries ago by the Andorian. The self-determination of the Menalvagorians and the treatment of minority Andorians is an issue of considerable controversy. The Elasi clan is the largest clan of pirates, and have been blamed for 46 attacks on Federation ships in the last 3 years. They use revolutionary zeal to mask their activities as pirates. Starfleet tactical analysis characterize them as being daring and impulsive, but skilled in analysis and planning. In effect, they are very capable of acting in an unorthodox and surprising manner when their plans begin to fall apart. They are considered a Class 1 threat to the Federation.
Yeah, really? I don't even remember them from the series. Wait.
Andorians. A member of the Federation noted for their antenna-like sensory organs and their unusual blue skin pigmentation. The Andorian colonization of Menalvagor, which was done centuries ago, has resulted in considerable problems for the Federation.
Menalvagor.
Menalvagor. the only inhabited planet of the Elasi Prime system. It was colonized by the Andorians before their entry to the Federation, and their relations with the native population has been a major problem with the Federation in recent years.
So they colonized a planet that already had species on it. Okay, I'm gonna save now, since that was an annoyingly difficult battle. Hope they don't get much harder than this.
Save new game.
What am I up to? 9? Now, it said he was going to this nearby star system, which the closest one is right here. And here we are.
The Harappan system is binary, with a neutron pulsar in the vicinity causing difficulties with our sensor readings. I was able to trace Mudd's transmission to this derelict.
So, our friend Harry is on board, no doubt. Can you tell me anything about the derelict vessel?
There are 6 major subdivisions within the hull. All systems are down. There is, however, limited atmospheric integrity. The environment appears to be the result of a temporary save-a-ship life support generator. Not exactly a reliable model, Captain.
You're being hailed by Mr. Mudd, sir.
Captain, oh, great. You came. I'm touched.
Harry, I have to be touched in the head. I have anything to do with you. How's your lovely wife, Stella?
That was a dirty trick, Kirk. However, you'll be glad to know I let bygones be bygones. If the Enterprise will stand by and fend off any pilots, I'll just finish my salvage operations here and be out of your hair.
Computer records document that you filed notice that there was no salvageable value here, and that the ship was a common passenger tug.
Did I say no value? Minimal, Captain, minimal. I meant nothing looked promising when I filed the report. We both know my judgment isn't always perfect.
I would say your judgment is never perfect, Harry. Perhaps we should beam over and judge the situation for ourselves.
Indeed.
Ah, that isn't necessary, Kirk. I can handle... I mean...
Harry, relax. We're old friends. We'll understand if things aren't picked up and looking neat. Kirk out.
Good call. Spock, anything else to say?
I would very much like to see this alien ship, but the prospect of dealing with Harcourt Fenton Mudd again gives me pause.
Hmm. All right, well, shields down.
Lowering shields, Captain.
Beam aboard.
Spock, come with me. Mr. Scott, you have the con.
Welcome, Captain Kirk. So glad you're here. The Elasi have been terrible trouble to me.
Well, you're terrible trouble to me, Harry. Tell me what this is all about.
I happened upon this ship not long ago and dutifully registered as salvage, mind you. In the hold here, I discovered one of these devices in that box over there. When I tried one on a wall, it floated off the grease and dirt. Perfect for cleaning, near as I could see. I peddled a few of these Mudd's Miracle Degrimers and everything was going perfectly well.
Then something went wrong, right?
Actually, no, Doctor, not then. I'd started offering a few other little items I found. Mudd's Limited Coffee Substitute, a great little specialty item. Lenses to affirm packaging build-your-own telescope kits. The collection of novelty paints, things like that. All of a sudden, the Elasi pirates are asking for me in every quadrant, wanting to know where I'm getting my goods.
I see, Harry. Well, we'll look around here while the Enterprise remains close by.
Look around all you like, Captain, but I'll be keeping an eye on you. I registered this derelict as my salvage, and I don't want you running off with all my prizes.
Harry, as official representatives of the Federation and of Starfleet, we recognize your rights to legitimate salvage. Need I say more?
I understand perfectly, Captain. Carry on, Captain.
Yeah. Legitimate salvage, which I'm not sure this is. I mean, I'm thinking this is all Elasi stuff he's selling. Let's look around at stuff. There's a box. I'll look at the box.
Odd-looking contraption, small enough to hold in one hand. Done.
What the hell exactly do we have? What is that?
One of Mudd's miracle degrimers.
Oh. Analyze this degrimer. Nope, guess not.
This place is cluttered with stored goods of every sort. It would take an army of workers weeks to examine every container and determine what is inside.
Well, Mudd only has himself.
James T. Kirk looks rather exasperated right now. Dr. McCoy looks like he would like to violate the Hippocratic Oath on Harry Mudd, but you know he won't.
And who's our red shirt today?
Lieutenant Buchard is standing around watching everyone else converse with Harry Mudd. Mr. Spock is as close to annoyed as a Vulcan can get.
Haha.
Harcourt Fenton Mudd. Of course he's going to be honest and fair with you.
And if you believe that, I got a bridge in the Andromeda system to sell you.
This place is cluttered with stored goods of every... You look but see nothing of note.
What's this?
This place is cluttered... This container holds bricks of what might have been pre-processed food a long time ago. This place is cluttered with...
Not this broken thing.
This container holds small mechanical components unfamiliar to you. You fail to obtain anything. You fail to obtain... You fail to obtain... You fail to obtain anything.
Oh, one of these.
Done.
Done.
Shiny dodecagons as long as one's hand. Highly reflective. Shimmering with the prismatic rainbow look of oil on water.
Hmm. Did I even look at this container?
There are shiny, multi-sided, spherical objects in this box.
How do I analyze this stuff?
This storage bay is stockpiled with all manner of goods.
He's gonna come down personally and look at himself.
A small energy device with a flanged opening at the front, about the size of one's thumbnail.
Nothing to report, Captain. Nothing to report, Captain.
How's Mr. Mudd doing, Bones?
There's nothing there requiring a ship's doctor.
Maybe more of a psychiatrist?
Given the past record of Harry Mudd, Captain, I strongly recommend that you do not trust him.
Mr. Spock!
No, really?
Whatever gave you that impression? I thought Vulcans were supposed to be logical.
I am. Your record is that of a greedy, amoral, sociopathic fraud who preys upon human emotion, most notably, gullibility.
For once, Spock, I couldn't have said it better myself.
Why, I've never been so insulted in all my life.
Hey, that's what we're here for, you know.
Jim, you can't seriously be thinking of helping Mudd after all he's done.
Bones, Federation law is clear on this. Federation law protects everyone, even Harry Mudd.
Yeah, and we all know how devoted I am to Federation law.
About as much as the Klingons are devoted to pacifism.
It's an imperfect universe. Ensign?
So, you say you know how to break the gambling machines on Kurlon 4.
It's a system that cost a gambler his life, boy. He crawled up to me and whispered it with his dying breath. And it can be yours for a mere 200 credits.
Sorry, Mr. Mudd. My mother didn't raise any fools in her family.
Starfleet! You're all the same. No sense of adventure!
This guy's like a walking infomercial or car salesman.
Kirk, my friend! When have I ever given you the slightest bit of trouble?
Only three or four episodes.
There was the time that you tried to commandeer the Enterprise to sell Wive to miners.
One.
And then there was the time you stole the Enterprise to exchange us for androids who were holding you prisoner.
Two.
Perhaps there have been a few minor misunderstandings.
Don't push your luck, Harry.
Yeah, there's three or four of those, so there's at least one more episode. I don't think there's anything else to look at in here, so...
Dust and grease lifts off the surface, leaving this item clean as new.
Alright, so I just cleaned him.
Nothing happens. Nothing happens. Nothing happens.
Alright, what if I try to use one of these things on each other? Nothing. Nothing happens. Alright, let's go, I guess, this way. Can we go this way? Never mind, too late. Dun, dun, dun. Danger.
A red triangular button.
Oh.
Three triangular blue buttons.
This is more like a magenta, though.
Two yellow triangular buttons.
Oh, brother. Puzzles.
The room reminds you of the weapons room of some old-style warships from the early days of starfaring. These cylinders have fallen down from the rest. An elaborate piece of alien-looking machinery. The room reminds you of the weapons room. The room reminds you of the weapons room of some old-style warships from the early days of starfaring. You look but see nothing of note.
What's this?
A large claw-like device hanging from the ceiling.
The claw! You cannot stop me, claw!
A row of unmarked cylindrical containers. An elaborate piece of alien-looking machinery.
One of these thingies.
The room reminds you...
Nothing.
Mr. Spock is looking forward to the moment that he can sit down at the main computer and analyze the findings of this mission. Lieutenant Bukert waiting for a chance to perform his duty.
Yes, to sacrifice yourself bravely as a red shirt.
James T. Kirk, dwarfed by the technology that surrounds him. McCoy is scowling... Probably from your meeting with Harcourt Fenton Mudd.
I'd say definitely.
A most interesting technology, Captain.
If the Elasi gets hold of this, they'll make Mudd seem like a perfect caretaker by comparison.
Hmm.
It looks to me like these people knew how to defend themselves, Captain.
That machinery in the middle of the room, however, is like nothing I recognize. And I thought I had seen just about everything.
What, this?
I wonder what's happening on the Enterprise right now.
Scotty will take good care of it, Jim. He has before.
I know, Bones.
I wonder where that Mud has gone. I wouldn't let him out of my sight. Mind you, I'm not too crazy about having him in my sight either.
Yeah. Okay, let's, analyze stuff.
The control panel has power running to it, Captain. Unique, Captain. I believe these are self-referencing packed quantum cartridges.
Power boosters! Oh, I've read about those, but they're just theoretical.
Evidently, these are more than theoretical, Lieutenant Bukert.
Hmm.
The energy initially released is infinitesimally small, but boosts itself until the power finally released is comparable to our photon torpedoes.
The technical journals discussing the possibilities indicated it would create a weapon of greater range than those we have now, if not a greater punch.
The machinery to deliver these cartridges would be an engineering feat as well, Captain.
Quite a lot of talk about these little cartridges, although they appear broken.
A weapons delivery system. It appears to be an accessory tied directly to the alien equivalent of our ship's phasers and photon torpedoes.
Hmm. What about this claw thing?
It seems to be part of a loading system for the weapon. It is also fully functional.
Fully operational.
Nothing to report, Captain. Nothing to report, Captain. Unique, Captain. I believe these are self-referencing packed quantum cartridges.
power boosters. Oh, I've read...
Evidently, these are more...
The technical journal is discussing the possibility...
The machinery to...
Okay, so these are not broken ones. These. I don't know what I'm talking about. Do stuff?
This is much too heavy to lift.
There is nothing at the moment for me to do there.